There's been a frenzied rush to develop apps specifically for the iPad. It's not every day you get a chance to get in on this kind of buzz. Some of the most ambitious players are the buzz generators themselves. News outlets. Let's take a look at how they've done. The Wall Street Journal, which, full disclosure, is owned by our parent company, has used the iPad to make a hybrid of their newspaper and website. For the most part, it works, especially if you subscribe. Choose from an archive of papers or the up-to-the-minute edition. You're greeted with something that looks a lot like a newspaper. Click on a headline to bring up the article, swipe to continue to the next page, and keep swiping for the next article or use the index. You can also fast forward to another section front by swiping up or down. From there, see a grid of articles within. The app moves one full page at a time, a lot like a newspaper. Its killer feature is the ability to save articles and whole sections to your personal collection, and to view complete editions of the paper offline. The commuter's perfect companion. Next up, National Public Radio. They've translated their top-notch website to the iPad with three main trays that swipe horizontally through stories. It's clean and intuitive. Click into a story to read and share, but this is radio after all, and the app shines once you actually play a story.
But we're going to open up this hour with a very special treat.
Keep listening while browsing through the rest of the site. It multitasks, so you can too. If we're picking nits, the app crashed a few times, and it's hit or miss if content from your local station will play. It would also be nice to download segments for listening offline. Still, this is a favorite that'll only get better. USA Today's app, unlike the previous two, can leave you guessing how to navigate. Swiping on the homepage does nothing. Want to get to another section? You need to click on the logo. It's also a little wonky. Want to take a poll? You have to give them your current location or no dice. Huh? The app's photo albums shine with large, crystal-clear pics presented like iPad's native photo viewer. Very nice. Once you're in a story, navigating makes more sense, but this app doesn't quite hit the iPad sweet spot. BBC News has also come out with a workhorse version of its site. Navigation is dead simple, with sliding, swipeable trays next to your chosen story. Swipe down for more categories, even browse the news in 8 other languages, which is pretty mind-boggling. Careful, though. If you turn your iPad to portrait mode, half the site disappears. The additional categories can't be accessed. Weird. It does let you listen to a live BBC radio feed while browsing, which is a plus. However, navigating would be easier if we could make the font larger than the app allows. This one's definitely for the eagle-eyed. The winners of the news app Rush for the iPad, the Wall Street Journal for offline reading, and NPR, the multitasker's dream. Happy browsing.